I'm Doug, your tech support representative here at Atlantic British, and in this video we're going to touch base on one of our maintenance kits we have available for the 02 to 05 Freelander, part of our maintenance and repair academy that you can find on our website. And on our website you can also find a sheet that's downloadable and printable that will also list all the other maintenance items that we have available for this vehicle. The one we're going to talk about right now is going to be the belt change kit, PQS 101 271L SKA, and this is essentially a kit that's going to allow you to change both the primary serpentine belt and the timing belts. Now there are three timing belts on this vehicle, and it is recommended every 60,000 miles, more so for the timing belt because these are critical. They take a lot of wear, and I've seen very many of them that at 70,000 these are pretty well done. It's a zero clearance engine, so you don't want to break a belt at say 65 miles an hour because it'll end up causing more internal damage. It's better to do the maintenance. In the long run, you'll get a lot better performance out of your vehicle. So what comes with the kit is your front main timing belt, your two rear timing belts, serpentine belt, hold down hardware, two new cam caps because you're going to be popping out the old ones in the process of changing over the timing belts, a new tensioner pulley, and a new idler pulley. And this is pretty much everything you're going to need. Now, the process for changing the timing belt on these is a little extensive, and what we're going to do is we're going to raise the hood on this, show you basic location, and then give you some tips on changing these over. Alright, so we've shown you the belt kit. Now, the actual repair or maintenance is actually rather extensive on these. If you have just a beginner's level of mechanical experience, I know you can do the majority of the maintenance on your vehicle, but this requires special tools and a lot of work. It's about a 4 to 5 hour job, even for an experienced technician. Somewhat complicated. So what we've done is basically we've filed instructions on our website. You can go to product instructions, go to the Freelander section, and you will see basically the instructions that we've downloaded from Rave, which is available on all the Land Rover forums and is actually really good source of information for just about anything on the earlier Land Rovers. So what you're going to find on the PDF files is initially camshaft timing belt. This is all the instructions from Rave on how to change the belts over. The way they have them set up on Rave and even in the Land Rover manuals, you get into part of the repair, and then it will refer you to another segment that you need to know, like in this case the beginning of the very beginning of the instructions for timing belt is going to have you remove the ancillary belt. So this is going to basically tell you to look over at charging and starting repairs, ancillary drive belt KV6. This will also be on those PDF files under our product instructions. So this is what it will refer you to, which gives you all the instructions to change over the serpentine belt. Now the serpentine belt requires taking the arm support, which actually holds up the right side of the engine assembly. So again, this is something you want to read through the instructions first and make sure it's something you feel you're comfortable with and changing over. When you get into the belts, you'll notice in the second step, it's going to now refer you to another section for engine repairs, arm assembly, engine mounting, right-hand side, which is this large bracket. Again, you will find this is the sheet that will give you that information. You'll find it under product instructions. We're going to list all these under PDF files so you can download and print them. And that will essentially get you to that point. Then, when you get back to timing belt, it will then get you to a point where you are now going to be removing the intake manifold. So, again, that refers you to a different section. We'll also have that file as a PDF on our product instructions, and we'll give you all the instructions for doing that segment of the repair. So as you can see, this is somewhat of a long maintenance repair, but it is strongly advisable you do this at the recommended mileages. These belts wear, they stretch, and because now with your new engine designs, what they refer to as zero clearance, you snap a timing belt at highway speed, you're going to cause internal engine damage. So it's best to have the timing belts done when they're supposed to be done. Very important on these. So now that you've read through it and you have a good idea whether this is something you want to tackle or not, or if you are a repair shop and you need the information to be able to do this repair for your customers, Call any of our knowledgeable salesmen at 1-800-533-2210. And thanks for watching.